Think Chief Meteorologist Kevin Robbins and joining us with potential for more of the same. Hi there.
Hey, good evening, Mike and Sheree. Yeah, I know a lot of folks still enjoying the tail end of the Memorial Day weekend this evening. The taste still ongoing. In fact, if you've got something to do outdoors, I would say probably about 90% of you are going to enjoy a rain-free evening around here. There's a small chance for just a few of you to get wet out here. Let me show you what's happening right now. Down along the Ohio River, southeast Indiana, northern Kentucky, it's all quiet, and for the most part, it's going to stay that way through the evening. Quick check in on the radar within the 275 loop. No showers or storms to speak of. In fact, with a warm front lifting across the area, we're beginning to see the sun poke back out for most of us. That's not the case, though. If you're up north, but you got to go north of Hamilton, you had some downpours earlier. That storm has shifted its way eastward into parts of Warren County right now, and it's pretty intense up there around Lebanon. Probably very noisy right now, especially on the north side of town. This thunderstorm getting awfully close to severe threshold here. No warning in effect at the moment, but dangerous cloud to ground lightning. You see a lot of that. It's moving in the direction of Oregonia, over towards Waynesville as well, drifting off towards the east northeast at about 35 miles an hour. I've thrown a time track on that. In Waynesville, it'll be there in the next few minutes. Looks like Massey as well. Kingman, as it moves into Clinton County along 71, should stay closer near north of the Wilmington area. In fact, I'm not sure if you can see here because I have the time track on the map, but the National Weather Service did just issue. You can kind of see the yellow box flashing. They just did to go ahead and decide to warn on this thunderstorm near Lebanon moving towards Oregonia, probably for the potential of some 60 mile an hour winds and more than likely some quarter size hail with this as well. So if you're in northern Warren into north central parts of Clinton County, you've now got a severe thunderstorm warning out in effect. And you can see Waynesville, Massey, Kingman all in line for this, as well as potentially Wilmington as it drifts off towards the east northeast. This is the exception versus the norm. Most of the thunderstorms tonight up around the southern Great Lakes, where they're dealing quite a bit in the way with some tornadic activity. The good news for us, this will move across Indiana tonight, but it will stay to our north as it dives into central Ohio. So around here, now that the sun's coming out, temperature's starting to heat up. Most of us are in the low 80s, and we're going to stay in the 80s, maybe 70s through a good part of the evening. In fact, feels like it's 84 here in Cincinnati. The farther south you go, it feels a lot hotter, closer to 90 across much of northern Kentucky. So if you got something to do this evening, aside from that storm to the north, most of us should be dry. Temperatures will hover around 80 as we slowly slip back into the 70s. Humidity levels creeping back up here this evening. Look at that dew point, almost around 70. So overall, the theme's not going to change much this week. A front's going to continue to be in the vicinity of much of the Midwest, and that will spell off and on shower and thunderstorm chances. I think for the most part tonight, it's pretty quiet. There may be, as that cluster of storms dives into central Ohio, we may see our northern counties get nipped with more storms towards morning. But otherwise, most of your Tuesdays should be dry. There could be a few pop-up storms during the day on Tuesday. And then it looks like quiet Tuesday night, and then better rain chances for showers and storms in here on Wednesday. Wednesday and Thursday look to be the two wettest days of the upcoming week for us. So, aside from that evening storm, 67 for an overnight low. And then for tomorrow, muggy sunshine with an afternoon storm threat, 86 for your high. Here's your day planner. You can see tomorrow we'll run the risk of a few more pop-up storms, especially in the afternoon and evening. Here's your 7-day forecast. There you have your weather impact days, Wednesday and Thursday. And then Mike and Sheree, it looks like we get a break from both the heat, humidity, and storms for a few days right there at the tail end of the week.
All right, sounds good, Kevin.
Thanks so much. A family camping trip turned into a...